Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Finance Tube. We still have Suresh with us and he has his string of questions for us today.
Yeah, because everyone says apna time aayega. But I've noticed one thing that what people do is end of the month, especially when you're working in organizations, the accountant calls up and says kuch invest karna padega. That time sab log sochte hain ki they'll invest and they'll make some money out of it. So typically what happens is they start borrowing from friends, neighbors, relatives, saying that they'll borrow money now, put it in some investment possible, and bonus aayega July mein tab de denge. So do you think this is a good trend, or is it a good idea, is it a smart move? Or maybe soch raha tha actually just to take randomly kuch loan lo or stock market mein dal do.
I mean, unless you want to disturb your good night's sleep, you should never do this. Because you are keeping open positions on both the ends. See, if you borrow from a friend, liability to fix ho gaya. Unless wo tumhare mein wapas karne ka riwaaj nahi ho. On the other side, the returns in share market is very uncertain. You know, if your company's share that you purchase is not performing, what can you do? Maybe write a letter to CEO saying that please cut down on your private jet trips. That's the only thing that you could do probably, and I don't know whether he's going to listen to you or not. So you know, it kind of opens position to sides. Matlab, you will be like drunk. In my opinion, borrowed money should never be invested in stock market. In fact, own money should also not be directly invested in stock market unless you understand it fully. My recommendation is invest in yourself first, become a better investor, then put money in stock market. Till that time, if you are a salaried person, if you are a corporate employee, look at mutual fund, look at ELSS, equity linked savings scheme. It not only gives you very good returns, but it also makes sure that you are getting tax breaks.
So, one more thing, talking insurance, what about life insurance policies? You know, a lot of people think that life insurance policies mein kafi safety hai, and they come and advise you ki, you know, you may die any moment. Sabse pehle, they always say that, what will happen to your family when you die?
I agree, but Suresh, today the trend has changed. You know, 60 years of mis-selling insurance to Indian public. Aaj bichara insurance agent jaake wo bechna ka try karta hai. You know, he tries to sell insurance policy and the prospective customer is asking, how much returns will I get? I say, yeah, I take out a gun, I put it on your head and shoot you, 100% return, immediately claim mil jayega. So, unfortunately, our society's mind is bent in such a way that they look at insurance also as an investment product. They don't look at it as risk cover. And if you try to sell pure insurance, nobody is going to buy. Said, "Humko kya hota hai? Nothing is going to happen to us. We live in the safest place on this planet." So.
हाँ, then they got this argument also. Road cross करते हुए मर सकते हो करके ना, वो भी है. तो काफी. So tell me something in संक्षेप में कि if I take a insurance policy, should I go for the term insurance or should I go for this cover, risk cover and plus investment and all those things that money actually gets added up to your fund.
So it is like this, you know, you're trying to buy a lot of things at the same time, which is bundled. You know, you go to these shopping malls in the end of season sales and they bundle up, you know, a packet of sugar and tea and cup and saucer, and then they say everything for 1000 rupees, but you see the quality is not good, right? So my advice to you would be that if you are really wanting to invest money, go for mutual fund. If you want to protect your life cover, you go for term plan. Because please understand in one line, okay, what is insurance? Insurance, suppose, God forbid, if something happens to you tomorrow, insurance company cannot get another Suresh Menon for your wife. What it can do is it can replace the income of Suresh Menon so that your family does not have to suffer. That is the bottom line of insurance. So my recommendation, go for term plan separately and buy mutual fund separately. Don't make a khichdi out of it and buy a ULIP plan, because, sorry, I'm using a technical word, marginal efficiency of your money invested will go down drastically.
Samajh gaya. Understood. Marginal efficiency of your money will go down drastically. I'll say, tell that to my wife when she goes out shopping also. Next time.
But make sure you hold your wife's hand when she shops, you know, not for the emotional reasons, but for economic reasons.
No, especially the right time where the credit card is going to get swiped up. I like that.
And just because of people like you, they've come up with credit cards which you don't have to now swipe. You just wave it and the money goes.
Arey papre.
So we, finance guys are always two steps ahead. You know?
Thank you. There's more to come from Vishal. I'll be back again on this episode because it's really wonderful.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Suresh.
Thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to be here and ask questions and get answers to them, write to us in the comment section. And if you haven't subscribed so far, subscribe today. Our channel, FinanceTube.